Hello and welcome. And in this 4 minute books, we will talk about the 31 best motivational books ever written. So this is very interesting books because here you will see the as the authors select some of the 31 best motivational books. So we will study them and what are those number of books and whether they are the fictional or non-fictional or classics, and that we will learn here. So one best motivational books ever written. So let's go through those books. Do you know that glowing feeling you get after you finish the last couple page of a really inspirational books? Do you know the sense of wonder, the goosebumps, the moment when you creatively seems to know no limits and you imagine yourself facing all of your challenges and succeeding? I think you should have that feeling more often. Recently, when I was sourcing the web for motivational books, none of the list I found really made me want to pick up one of the book, mostly because I knew all the books already. The books were only for a specific demographic: entrepreneurship, women, etc. Or they did not even tell me why the book was going to motivate me in the first place. What's more, every single list I found was limited to either fiction or non-fiction books only. So I thought, why not create one with both? To keep it fair and square, I limit myself to include only books I either have read or am currently reading. This way, I make sure I only present you with books I have a solid understanding of and which are, to my best of 25 years old knowledge, utterly motivating. After digging deep, I even called my mom. I have come up with a list of what I believe to be the 31 best motivational books ever written. So that's unless you inner greatness. So for every book I have included, so there is a title, author, year of publications, an image of the cover with a link of the book. So number of copies sold, add a curious fact, some summary, and the best quotes from the book, and a shareable image with the quote why it is so motivational, and two way to share the books depending on whether you have already read it or not. And of course, a link of read it summary right here of 4 minute books. For the fiction books, I have included the links. So since I only read non-fictions for this site. So don't be surprised to see quite a few children's books and books for teenagers. Since I am only 25 years old, I still remember a lot of those. So plus kids are the most motivated human beings on the planet. As adults, we have lost most of the light-hearted, curious, motivational mojo, and those books are a great way to get it back. Now without further ado, enjoy what I think are the top 31 motivational books of all time. The 31 best motivational books ever written. To make negatives the post super easy, you can jump right to any books that spark your interest from the table of contents below. So below in the box is the content for the fictional books. So let me tell you one by one. So you will find a black back of top link of to come and here and pick the next one. The Alchemist, the fiction books. In the fiction books, we have 15 books. First is The Alchemist, then the Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, third Pippi Longstocking, fourth Artemis Flow, fifth Adventures of Tom Sawyer, sixth The Little Prince, 7. Measuring the World, 8. The Da Vinci Code, 9. A Christmas Carol. 10. A Hunger Games. Catching Fire. 11. In Heart. Number 12. The Great Gatsby. Number 13. Sherlock Holmes. A Study in Scarlet. Number 14. The Richest Man in Babylon. Number 15. Around the World in 80 Days. In non-fiction books, we have another 15 books. So what those are? Non-fiction books, we have Managing Oneself. 16. 17. Choose Yourself. In the 18. The War of Art. 19. Start with Why. 20. The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. 21. When I Stop Talking, You Will Know I Am Dead. 22. The Happiness of Pursuit. Number 23. Rich Dad and Poor Dad. 24. The Deep. 25. Sam Walton, Made in America. Sam Walton, Made in America. 26. The 4-Hour Work Week. 27. So Good They Cannot Ignore You. 28. The Miracle Morning. 29. 0 to 1. And 23. The Power of Less. And in the hidden bonus, we have number 31 is a secret bonus book. So guys, the first book is The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho, and this is a fictional book and it's published in 1988. And Paulo Coelho sell more than 65 million, and he also received the world record because of the book has translated into 80 different languages and making Paulo Coelho the Guinness World Record holder for being the most translated living author in the world. And now the best quote from the book is, when you want something, all the universe conspired to help you achieve it. Now let me summarize this book for you. So in a summary, a young sharp boy in southern Spain has the same dream about hidden treasures in Egypt over and over again, which eventually led him to investigate it. He learned that one day everyone find out what their destiny is and what it's require, passions and desire to make your destiny become a reality. Along the journey to find the treasures, he meet new and strange people, some of which become his friend and touch his heart. The combined teaching of his companion finally led him to the realization that it's much bigger than even the treasure's life. So the quote is, when you want something, all the universe conspired to help you achieve it. Now, why is it such a motivational book? So the book's core theme is a destiny. This is combined with many mysterious character and deep, thoughtful lessons, often in the form of riddles and puzzles. Yet the book such plain language that anyone can understand it. That's how the books constantly speak to you, curiosity without making you feel overwhelmed. It's impossible to put down, leave you with the sense of wonder and gratitude about a world, and give you an incredible drive to explore your own destiny. I remember finishing it in a very few sittings, over the course of which I started going to bed at 9 p.m. even though I was studying abroad in the US at a time with a 5 party animals as a roommate, waking up at 5, watching the sunset. I remember finishing it in a very few sittings and walking around in the nearby forest a lot and beginning to think about what I really want out of life. That's the power of the book, has it make you think a lot. Number 2 is Harry Potter and Goblet of Fire. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire is written by J.K. Rowling. Johnny जॉनी के रोलिंग, और इन शॉर्ट जे के रोलिंग. He published these books in 2000s and the number of copies sold is 55 million. J.K. Rowling changed her mind about the title twice until 12 days before it was published. The already publicized work title was Harry Potter and the Doomspell. The best quote from the book, "It's matter not what someone is born, but what they grow to be." So, in a summarize, in this book, fourth year at Hogwarts, the school hosted the legendary Triwizard Tournament. For the first time in 202 years, where three wizards from three schools compete in a Gryffindor trials for fame and glory. Technically too young to compete, Harry mysteriously end up as the fourth participant and soon has to face challenge he doesn't feel remotely ready for. With luck, friends, braves and skills, he preserves until the end, only to find he finally has to take responsibility not only for whole he is, but also for the entire wizarding world. Now, the quote is, "It matters not what someone is born, but what they grow to be." So, why it is such a motivational book? I am huge Harry Potter nerd, and so show me that the reasons this book stand out to me among the series is that it leads Harry to go through a vital transformations. In these first three books, he short stumbles into things and by looking out for himself somehow ends up saving the day. While he is thrown into cold water in the book, once again he makes the decisions to stop try to be normal and instead takes responsibilities. This is a crucial part of seeing him succeed in all the tournament challenge, which by the way are much tougher than all the other things he faced in the three previous books combined. This is a book about the things in life worth fighting for, not only because Harry finds love for the first time, but also because things become deadly or serious. For teen, this is an identity shaping book, but I have read it multiple times over the year because it teaches you that there is always a choice between what is right and what is easy, and make you want to take responsibility for taking the path you feel is right. Now, the third book in our list is Pippi Longstocking by Astrid Lindgren. So, Pippi Longstock by Astrid is a fictional book, and it's published in 1945, and the number of copies sold is almost 80 million. The series of total for books. So, a series of total three books plus three picture books. So, curious fact is the main character is Sittig Lerson, is a three book series of Millennium novel, is a based on what he believed to be an adult version of Pippi and Longstocking. So, the series has sold 80 million copies, just as many as the Pippi Longstocking books. So the best quotes from the book is, "I have never tried that before, so I think I should definitely be able to do that." Now, summary is the Pippi Longstocking is an estimated 9-year-old, and though no one knows for sure, so has superhuman strength, has superhuman strength, and lives in a rainbow colored house with her monkey, Mr. Nelson, and her horse, an old man. So she takes care of herself entirely as her father and mother and famous seafarer has been lost at sea for a few years after dropping her off in the village because he thought life at sea was too dangerous for her. Although Pippi has no manners, cannot do maths and neither read nor write, she lives an extraordinary life. Life filled with adventures or mostly involving the neighbors, kids, and show that living by the world's rule is hopelessly overrated. She never caused to shock adults, but is living proof that you can make the world what you want to be without fitting you any template the world would call normal. So that is in the book. And what is the such a motivation books? Why this is called such a motivation? Now, this is a Swedish book and much more widely known in Europe than overseas. So you might never have heard of Pippi and her story. I especially love the TV movies and series in 1969 versions. So as a kid, because it made me believe that anything is possible, even the intro song suggested it. Among the lyrics, where lyrics are the words 2 times 3 is 4, wild, and 3 makes 9. The constant conflict between the adults who try to get Pippi to comfort to what they think is normal and Pippi's sheer intolerance for anything that doesn't match her idea of fun, happiness and adventures, in which Pippi always come out on top, really makes you question a lot of ideas we grow up with. Pippi refused to grow up. And when you start to look at all the things you have slowly let go of and give up on over the years, you will see that maybe it might be time to bring a little bit or a lot of that childish inexpensive, unbiased, bold, let's do it attitude back to your own life. So in this video, this is all about, because video is going to be long, and in the next part we will discuss the rest of them. So thanks for watching and keep watching.